Please welcome on stage Daniel Lienert.
So, hi, I'm Daniel from Punkt.de, and yeah, my showcase is about an all-in digital transformation for a publisher. And the publisher, our client, is a publisher specialized for insurance literature in Karlsruhe. And till now, they have different channels where they publish their content. They have a shop and a news portal, they have books, they have magazines, and they have a newsletter. And they came to us because they wanted to have one content pool, which then feeds all these different publishing channels from one centralized content pool. And they also have had a structure in mind, and this structure is DITA. I don't know if you know DITA. It's XML standard, stands for Digital Information Type Architecture, DAVA Information Type Architecture. And it's an XML standard like DocBook, maintained by the Oasis committee. And it's special meant for being used by publishers. And one central idea is the topic. They have different XML elements. They have about 800, but there is this topic element, and in this topic element, this is meant to be a self-contained information item. Topic, you can think about it like a chapter where you have a title and a content in it, and it can be understood as it is. And like a chapter for a book, there are many of these topics, and these topics are linked from a map. And such a map contains metadata and also the links to the other topics. And then there are other maps, for sure. And one of the benefits from DITA is that you can reuse content. You can link content from one map to the other. And so you, for example, can reuse the information about an offer from one book to the other. So now we have this content structure, and we needed a database or a storage for this data, and we need a database that is online accessible, where we can traverse through all these XML nodes from the map down to the metadata and to all these topics. And yeah, Neos is great in storage such structured content because we have the content repository. And what we did is we took about 100 of the 400 XML node types and modeled Neos node types from it. So we store every single XML element as node type and as node in the content repository. So now we have the structure and we have a database. So we need an interface so that the editors can put content into this structure. For this, we build a DITA view for the backend, where the user can see the content like it's like an XML structure. It can add data, move data. They have all their attributes at hand. And you may imagine that a document has now a lot of content nodes. And thankful there was this Neos rewrite, because the new React Neos UI is capable to hold this complete and hold and present this complete structure. And it's really great that we could sponsor part of this rewrite, and that we have the core team members that worked on this Neos rewrite at hand, so we could fix all the problems we had. And we also have the first special components, React components. Here, for example, we have an Excel-like table editor where the editors can put in structured Excel data and also copy data from Excel directly into the content repository, which really helps. So now we have the structure in the database and we put data into it. Now it comes to rendering. We have two different, completely different types of rendering. We have the web rendering on the one hand, and we have the magazine rendering on the other hand. Web rendering is pretty easy because that is what Neos is for. We have a continuous content streams with content stream with images and content, and we have no limitations of pages and such. And on the other hand, we have an article in a magazine, for example, which has pages, which has fixed elements where we put pictures in. We have page numbers. We have a left and right side, and yeah, we need a solution for that. So. Yeah, rendering in Neos is pretty easy for the web part, but we needed something for the print documents, and the industry standard is InDesign, and we use that. And InDesign has a JavaScript-ish interface with which you can remote control it. And here we got great help from Florian from Sandstorm, which built a remote control JavaScript and also an Electron app. Thank you very much. An Electron app which pulls the data from the content repository and then fills it in together with the JavaScript from the InDesign into templates. Yep, it works like that. We have about 50 different templates, and the editor can choose some of them. Ah. Clicker exchange. Yeah, the editor can select some of them, and then the content that it edits is filled in there. I have a little video. Oh, the same problem here. This one isn't. Ah, yeah. Okay. A little little video showing that. So it isn't working good. Yeah. Okay. We have this article, and we can show it in the web, and then the editor copies the URL into the Electron app, and this pulls the content from the repository and uses this JavaScript to fit it into InDesign. And now we have the complete article rendered with the correct page numbers in the correct templates. And this one can be printed, it's then a physical magazine. Okay, I feared from the beginning that that our content repository isn't capable to hold that much nodes, because when we split up every single part of content into small node types which represent the XML types, we get lots and lots of nodes, and currently we have about 1,200 author representation, 7,500 news, 1,600 magazine articles, and about 1,500 book meta information. So this is the information which you find on Amazon, for example, for a book. And that results in about 400,000 nodes. And yeah, this one is the same. 400,000 nodes. And Yeah, I can say if you keep some things in mind, things you already know, that you don't put that much nodes on the same level so that the backend responds correctly, and there are also some problems with node migrations, which we tackled for the next version. It's pretty responsive, and it works with that 400,000 nodes. And that's really great. Currently, we are working on importers for complete books, and every book will have about 20 to 50,000 nodes, and we have to import 3,000 books. So we push it to the next level. But yeah, if you think, if you want to use the content repository for that, that is really doing the job. Okay, I have some minutes left. What do we do with this content? Every content thing, every article, every news article, every book is categorized in different dimensions. Some are publication types. Is it a book? Is it an article? Or usage types? Is it for research, education, or knowledge? Focus topics like risk management or compliance, and for which profession is it, for economy, for law, for mathematics. And then we have an overview of all this content, and the user of the portal can filter this content into his or her view. For example, it can filter it by the type or by different dimensions. Yeah, and we have a filter editor. It's written in React, backed by a GraphQL API, where the user can build their own filters and then apply this filter on the complete content. And it's rendered live. It's fetched from Elasticsearch, and it's pretty fast, and works out. So yeah, the portal is currently in a beta status, in a closed beta. We will publish it on May. It will be called Be in Value, and yeah, if it appears on the web, just have a look. And if you have any questions, the complete team that built the thing is here at the conference, so just come to us and ask questions. Thank you very much.